Hello, and welcome to the Monsoon Outlook briefing provided by the National Weather Service in Flagstaff. This briefing will spend the next few minutes discussing what the monsoon is and how it affects Arizona and the greater southwestern United States. We will then transition into how we go about making monsoon season predictions, the 2013 outlook, and what we can expect this year. Keep in mind, as with any of our outlooks, they are subject to change and are simply designed to help you plan ahead and be prepared for the upcoming season. So what is a monsoon? Well, contrary to popular usage, a monsoon is not a heavy thunderstorm or a heavy downpour. Actually, a monsoon is a seasonal reversal of the prevailing winds, which leads to associated changes in precipitation patterns. Here in Arizona, westerly winds which prevail during the spring begin to lift north with the jet stream by early summer. This allows the winds to become southerly or southeasterly across the region, allowing moisture to flow northward into the southwest. Arizona's monsoon season begins June 15th and lasts through September 30th, though often the first significant moisture surges hold off until early July. A large fraction of the annual rainfall across the state comes during this time of year, especially in southern Arizona, where some locations receive more than half their annual total during the summer months. While the rainfall is always a welcome relief from the dry summer months, storms commonly bring with them the threat of heavy rain and flash flooding, as well as dangerous lightning, among other hazards. So how do we predict the monsoon, you ask? Well, firstly, it's important to state that the southwestern monsoon is not easily predicted, and there is limited skill in anticipating if the monsoon will be wet or dry. Additionally, due to the small-scale nature of showers and thunderstorms, rainfall can vary dramatically over the course of the summer from one point to another, so while one location may finish above normal, it may not be representative of the whole region. With that said, one indicator we often look for large-scale climate signals is the Southern Oscillation, better known as El Niño or La Niña. While the state of the Southern Oscillation provides insight into our winter seasonal outlooks, its summer influence is much less pronounced and poorly understood. Unfortunately, the current state of the Southern Oscillation is neutral and is expected to remain that way for at least the next several months, so it adds little indication as to what to expect for the summer monsoon. It has been such a dry winter and spring, could that mean a wet summer? Well, unfortunately, there is very little statistical support for dry winters or springs leading to a wet summer. It really can go either way. There is some research supporting a decreased snowpack in the Intermountain West, favoring a wetter monsoon for parts of the Southwest. This year, snowpack is well below average across much of the western U.S., but this factor alone doesn't provide a lot of support for an outlook greater than equal chances. Ultimately, it comes down to when and where the Four Corners High sets up. The earlier it sets up and the more persistent it is, the better chances for an active monsoon. While if the Four Corners High is weak and fails to materialize until later in the summer, it may lead to a drier season overall. Alright, it's time for what you've all been waiting for, the official prediction for the 2013 monsoon season. Well, as stated in the previous slide, we have few indicators to work with this year favoring a monsoon going one way or the other. We also have little indication of the onset being early or late, and probably won't have for at least several more weeks. Therefore, the official outlook calls for equal chances of above, below, or near normal precipitation. Greater confidence in dry conditions exists further to our east in New Mexico, where a persistent multi-year drought and low soil moisture may continue. Keep in mind, monsoon rainfall can vary dramatically from one point to another, and your home locations may not necessarily reflect what fell down the street. Take this example of the summer rainfall last year in this Flagstaff area. While the Flagstaff Airport was repeatedly missed by the heaviest downpours over the course of the summer, nearby Belmont, only about 10 miles northwest of town, in the same general climate and elevation, received over twice as much rainfall during the same time period. This goes to show how feast or famine the monsoon can be, and further highlights how difficult it can be to predict. So here's what we can expect, regardless of exactly how the monsoon behaves. We can expect to see a significant uptick in cloud cover and precipitation beginning in July, with the heaviest rainfall coming in August before tapering off in September and October. Some of the higher elevation locations can receive rainfall nearly every day during the more active points in the season, while lower elevations will get rainfall, but less frequently. Lightning is also a significant hazard with our monsoon season storms, with over 1.5 million lightning strikes occurring in Arizona and New Mexico each year. It's important this time of year to be safety conscious and go inside when thunder roars. Heavy downpours can bring with them the threat of flash flooding, especially in small drainages and canyons, and can flood urban areas as well. Of especially great concern is locations near recent burn areas, as the burned forests and hillsides cannot absorb the heavy rainfalls as they could in the past, leading to rapid flash flooding, rockfall, and mud and debris flows. Strong storms can also bring with them gusty winds and microbursts, which can be damaging at times. While rare, isolated tornadoes have also been known to occur and are especially a big concern towards the tail end of the monsoon season. Finally, expect bursts and breaks throughout the season as changing weather patterns dictate where the greatest moisture goes. When the Four Corners High is favorably situated in the southwest, active weather and daily thunderstorm chances will dominate the forecast, while occasional surges of dry, stable air from the west will disrupt the pattern, leading to periods of dryness. Thanks for watching, and be sure to follow us on our various social media outlets, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Stay tuned also for the Monsoon Safety Awareness Week, which is coming up, for additional information about local hazards and how to prepare for them as we head into the summer season.